As you're cruising along in MATLAB, it's really important to remember not to do dumb stuff. So dumb stuff would be like this. Say you're cruising along, you're like, I've got some variables. I've got like age is 5 and I is 8 and J is 10 and K is 14 and blah, 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 blah. And then like some 50 lines later, you're doing something and you're like, okay, so I've got this whatever, and whatever is equal to the square root of negative 25, so that's 5i. And then like further on down the line, you're like, okay, so whatever, I'm doing it again. And so it's still the same thing, it's still the square root of negative 25, so it's 5 times I. And it shouldn't matter whether I'm at 5i or 5 times I, because we talked about this, and this should be totally fine. Sorry, CLC here. But anyway, so you're like, oh, happy, and you run your code, and you're like, oh no, this makes me really sad. So what's happened here? You overwrote a very, very super important value, which is the square root of negative 1. So remember that I is, it's not officially reserved, but I is supposed to be the square root of negative 1. So if I have CLC clear and I just type I get the square root of negative 1. But if I go run my code, MATLAB here is smart enough to know that if I say 5i, I mean 5 times the square root of negative 1. But if I say 5 times I, it's like, oh, well, you must really mean that other I up here. And this can be incredibly confusing if you are looking at someone else's code and they do stuff like this. So please, please, please never, ever, ever, ever use I as an index. And similarly, I'm just going to copy this, never, ever, 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 ever use J as an index. So if you've done programming before, there's like a part of you that wants to go for I equals 1 to N and blah, 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 which is totally fine. But don't say for index goes from 1 to N, because I actually stood for index. So say for index. And if you know what I'm talking about with for loop, don't worry about it. But I'm just telling you, if you programmed before, it's very, very normal to want to use I, like I going from 1 to N. Don't do that. And don't let J, because you know you're used to having these nested for loops where I goes from 1 to N, and then you have J going from 1 to N. And now you just really mess things up because you've overwritten the value of the square root of 1 twice. Like, well, I'm never going to use the square root of 1, negative 1. But you never know if someone else who's going to be using your code like, you know, 100 years later or like 5 years later is going to do the same thing. And this is how you end up with problems like, you know, Windows 98 or whatever. So, never, ever, 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 ever use I or J, because CLC clear, J is the square root of negative 1 because of electrical engineers. I is the square root of negative 1 because of real people. I'm sorry, y'all are real people too. But anyway, I digress. So just to be obnoxious, of course, you can always go and you can write over the value of pi. So whenever you're coming along later and you got the area of a circle is 2 pi r squared. I don't know why r is 6, it just happens to be. Then you get this really crazy number. Whereas if I was going to do this for real, then I'll just clear pi. You can actually just clear a single value out at once. So if I clear out pi, my area is only supposed to be 226. So that's also kind of fun. So if you watch over here on my variables, if I just want to clear out area, it removes area. I can clear out I, I can clear out j. So that's all I did here, is I just cleared pi so I wouldn't have to delete everything else. So there you go. Don't overwrite stuff. I mean, MATLAB will let you, but don't. Here are other things that it likes to use. Inf, and you've probably seen that before. Inf is a very, very large number, so if I just hold the 9 for a while, I don't know how long I have to hold it. That should be enough. And I hit, seriously? I go 999 times 10 to the 99999. That should be good. Infinity. Okay, so that's a really, really big number. All right, so that's infinity. I think you can also, almost positive, you can get negative infinity. Yeah, negative infinity. NaN, not a number. So if I say 1 divided by 0, oh, really, you're giving me infinity? 0 over 0? What do I have to do to get you to give me not a number? There we go. I don't know why it gives me 1 over the other thing, but it just does. So make a note of these, of what they are. So, stuff not to overwrite. So, pi, obviously, I, j, so this is infinity. It's not like truly infinity, it just means infinity as far as the computer is concerned, not a number. Clock, you're like, what's clock? And you just type in clock, and it's like, what? This is actually kind of hard to read, but this is 1 times 10 to the 3 times all these numbers. Personally, I hate looking at it like this. So you can go format bank right quick, and that'll format everything with two decimal places. And if you go clock, you can see the day and time that I'm making this. 2014, November 30th, 0 o'clock, 5 minutes and 50 cents, apparently right after midnight. Yes, okay, so anyway, hey guys, this is what I do past midnight on a Saturday. This makes me so cool. So, clock, current date and time. I don't know what date does then, probably just the date. There you go. Alright. Date. Duh. Eps. You're like, what is that? Alright, so I'm going to go back to a regular format, and I'm going to type eps again. Alright, see, it's just a really, really small number. Literally, that's what it is. A really, really small number. So there was a little while ago where we had a conversation about the fact that the sine of pi is not actually 1. In fact, that's like smaller than my epsilon. It's kind of unnerving. But that makes sense. It should be smaller than the epsilon. So we talked about, like, if that's smaller than a really, really, really small number, then we count it as 0. And so we'd say if the sine of pi is less than that epsilon, then say hi. And then it said hi. See, hi. But epsilon is just a really, really small number that's reserved in MATLAB for people who like to do stuff like that. If you don't know what I'm talking about, don't worry about it. That's not as important as the fact that you just didn't override it. The ones you should really be concerned about are like inf, not a number, clock, date. Because you could see, like, if you're programming, you want to call something date, like, you know, January. But then you've overwritten date, and date isn't supposed to do that. Date is supposed to give you that. Alright, but MATLAB will let you overwrite it, and that's always kind of frustrating because MATLAB will let you do that. INJ, what's the difference with INJ? Nothing. It's the same thing. So again, MATLAB will totally let you do this. It will let you overwrite the value of pi, it will let you overwrite the value of negative squared of negative 1, and all these other things. The only thing it won't let you overwrite is if you type it and it turns blue. So I can't say 4 equals 3, and I can't say while equals 3, and I can't say end equals 3. If it turns blue, loop doesn't, next, loop doesn't do, doesn't, all right, so I think it's just return, that one would turn blue, break, turns blue. So if it turns blue, I can't overwrite it, but there are very, very few variables in MATLAB, or very, very few reserved keywords in MATLAB that you can't overwrite. Pretty much anything else you can't overwrite, really screw up your code later, so just keep an eye out for those.